let me tell you, it is a party up in here tonight.
I am ready to eat some food, okay? I'm ready to eat Macca's, yeah. Oh, it's really sad because you can't see the food.
You know, like people who actually do like mukbangs. You know, like people who actually do it, you can see all the food. Like, that's part of it, but listen. Listen, okay?
Listen.
Okay, what is actually wrong with me today? You need to, like, calm your schedules. I don't have the equipment, the right situation here right now for you to be able to see the food. So we can just, like, imagine it in our heads, you know? Like, okay.
Boys and girls, it is your girl Jordan back at it again with another YouTube video. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. If you're new here, thank you so, so much for being here. If you like what you see, maybe subscribe if you want to. It's the big red button down there if you feel like it. Don't have to. I don't want to sound too YouTubery on you. And boy, are you in for a treat. Well, actually, I'm in for a treat because listen, I got some Macca's. Today we are doing something a little bit different, but something I've wanted to do for a while. Now, I don't know about you guys. I thought that was a spider then. I basically shat my pants. But yeah, I don't know about you guys, but I'm obsessed with watching mukbangs, mukbongs. I'm not really sure you say it. I don't really know like the lingo over here, but I am obsessed with watching people like eat and just like chat about anything and everything for like an hour. It's so satisfying to me. And it's just like so chill to just be able to just stick on a video and just like let it play and just like listen. And I don't know. You know the kind of videos where you don't really have to concentrate and it's fab. That is what we're doing today. We are gonna be doing a McDonald's mukbang because who doesn't love McDonald's? Honestly, I wish I had like a whole layout and I got like a crap ton of food. I did only get enough food to feed me because there's no one here to eat it and I don't want to waste food, you know? Trust me, it's sad when you see a chicken nugget go to waste. Let's just pretend that worked. Honestly, you know what drink is mine every single time because the lipstick troubles.
Wow, I was thirsty.
So I just got a Coke because, right. Let me just like give you the tea on McDonald's, okay? I don't know whether McDonald's have just like not got their stuff sorted or like what's going on. Every single time, okay, we go to this McDonald's, which is like the closest one to us, every single time. And when I say every single time, I mean every single time. The frappe machine and the milkshake machine is legit broken. Like, how can that be a thing? They're like, yeah, sorry, it's not working today. We don't have any milkshakes or frappes. And I'm like, I don't think it's broken. Honestly, I think it's a conspiracy theory. If you look it up, like Google like conspiracy theories from McDonald's and you should be able to find it. I low-key believe it. Like I actually think it's legit. Food-wise, I got 9 chicken nuggets, of course. Some chippies. Why do McDonald's like never fill their chips up? Like, hello. I got a cheeseburger and I also got some of their like cheese bite things because these are so good. And some sauces. They're giving me ketchup. I'm not really a ketchup gal. I'm more of like a sweet and sour girl. First chip of the day. It's kind of cold, but I mean, I can still fuck with it. So basically I asked you guys what you kind of wanted me to talk about, what you wanted me to cover in this video. And a lot of you just sort of said, it's kind of a bit like girl talk. A lot of you wanted girl talk. What I mean by that is talk about self-love, confidence, relationships. Also YouTube was quite popular as well. You also wanted a bit of goss and a bit of tea, so I'm sure I'll spill a little bit today, so you know, get ready. And some of you wanted to know like a little bit about me as like an actual human being, which is kind of crazy to me because I am literally just Jords. But yeah, I don't really know what I'm gonna cover today. I'm just gonna sit, I'm just gonna chat and just see what literally comes out of my mouth.
Honestly, cheese bites are so good. Okay. I feel really rude like talking and eating at the same time, just like don't mind me.
So a lot of you were asking me if I've got anything going on behind the scenes. I've kind of mentioned something before on an Instagram live, so I think that's where it's come from. And the answer to that is yes.
Guys, trust me, okay? It has been so hard not to tell you anything and I still can't. However, all that I'm gonna say is it's super, super exciting and you should know towards the end of the year, so in like a few months. That is all I can say, otherwise like my management will kill me. But I've been working on it for a while. And yeah, you'll find out soon enough anyway, like it's all chill. On to next.
So yeah, that's definitely like one thing that's happening. I am trying to get involved with something else, but it's a bit of a harder like industry, not industry, because it sounds like it's something that I don't do. I do it.
doo-doo. I don't know, we're just like working on it and seeing what we can do. When you want something so bad, you want to work for it. But I believe in like fate a lot, and you know, if something happens, it happens. If it doesn't right now, it's, you know, it's not meant to be. And when it wants to happen, it will happen, and it'll be the right time, and it'll be great. You guys are probably like, what the frick, Jordan? Like, you probably have no idea what I'm talking about, but basically, job-wise, I'm trying to get involved and do as much as I can and just kind of work hard to make my dreams happen, because I'm lucky enough to be, you know, have a job that I absolutely love, which is amazing. So yeah, there's definitely one big thing happening towards the end of the year, and everything else will just kind of like fall into place, I hope, as and when. But yeah. Sponsorships. Let me just like talk about sponsorships for real, like really, really quick. I might not bore you. As you know, YouTubers do sponsorships. Like, that's the thing, you know. At the end of the day, when it's our job, that is how we earn money. And there's a difference between doing something with a brand who you love and doing it because you're passionate about it and earning money like that, and doing something because you're gonna get a few grand in the bank account. There is a big difference, and I feel like a lot of people see sponsorships as a bad thing, especially when, you know, you're not in that industry. Girl, we gotta hustle, do you know what I mean? But there's like hustling and then like taking the piss, you know? I get why some people might think, oh my god, you do sponsorships all the time, like it's not a good thing. But like, let me use me as an example. You guys are 100% gonna be seeing more sponsored videos from me. Like, I'm gonna keep it real with you guys. I've got like 4 or 5 more coming up in the next month, 100%, which is a lot. And I never normally take that much. And I've tried so hard with my management to like really split it up. But of course, brands want certain things up at certain times and they won't budge. So unfortunately, there will be moments where I might have 2 sponsored videos up in a row, or there might just be like a collection of them in one little short space of time. However, what you guys don't see is I turn down a lot of stuff. Think about how many brands there are in the world. Just my cheap bites. Think about that, you know, like, the amount of brands that will want to work with people is crazy. So doing 4 or 5 really isn't as bad as you think. I've only accepted them because I've had brands, and I'm sure every single one that I'm doing, you have 100% heard of. And I don't want to turn down a relationship with a brand just because I'm worried about what people are going to say about me doing a sponsored video. Like, it is all legit over here. Now, on this channel, it is legit. We don't do stuff for the sake of it. Listen, my trust with you guys and my reputation in that respect is way more important than getting a few pounds in my bank account, because girl, I'm not a sellout. I never will be. I will do brands I love and make my money that way, and enjoy what I do, than sit here and pretend that I love something and you should go buy it, when really it's like shit and I don't know the brand. Anyway, that was like a bit of a rant, but all I'm saying is you're gonna be seeing a few from me. I'm just doing what I love, working with the brands I love, and doing things that will benefit you guys as well, you know, promoting stuff that I love and I know that you guys are gonna love. So yeah, that was a whole nother rant that just happened. Okay.
I also forgot to mention that anytime I do sponsored videos as well, I always ask the brand to get something for you guys, whether it's a discount code, money off or something, just because, you know, girl, you work hard for your coins. You shouldn't have to spend a shit ton of money, you know? But yeah, just wanted to mention that.
Let me get like a chicken nugget out, you know, like. Talking about sponsorship, McDonald's, if you wanna hit a gal up, then I'm not gonna be mad, you know? joking, JK. Oh, I can't open my sweet and sour. Nailed it. Oh my god, ASMR. Oh, that is disgusting, I can't. Speaking of ASMR, actually, I really, really wanna do a ASMR like responding to hate comments video. I think that's so funny. I've watched like Jeffree Star's and Jackie Aina's, and I think they're like the best thing ever, and I really want to do one now. I just think it's jokes. I feel like you either get ASMR or you don't, and I feel like just doing a responding to hate comments video, I don't know, it just makes it 10 times funnier, because obviously like hate and stuff, like, there's a thing, but you know what, like, you have to just like not take it seriously, because it's just like, babes, like, you don't actually know me. I don't know, I'm just trying to include more fun stuff on my channel, you know, stuff that I genuinely watch outside of me being this side of the camera, you know. That noise. Sipping on drink. It's literally just Coke. I broke the lid. Why do I feel like I'm getting full already and I've just had some cheese bites and one chicken nugget? Okay, right. What do you guys think of the YouTube scene these days compared to how it used to be? Especially if you're like a vivid watcher. Vivid? That's not the word I needed.
I am a mess in today's video. Vivid, Jordan? Vivid? I think you meant avid. Wow.
Basically, if you watch YouTube for a long time, what do you think about it now? Right. I'm not sure how I feel about it anymore. I just feel like YouTube for a lot of people has become a competition and it like kind of grosses me out and it's kind of cringy. There are some YouTubers which, how can I put it out? They see YouTube as who can earn the most views, who can do the biggest clickbait. I don't know, and it's just kind of sad because we all do the same thing here. People get so hung up on views and how much money they earn, and I get it being your job, you have to think about these things, and I'm not sitting here and saying that I don't sit here and look at views on a video, and if one doesn't do so well, you know, I'm not a little bit gutted. I'm not saying that, that's so normal. I know people who like have got like not so good views on a video and want to delete the video, and I'm like, but babes, you spent so much time on that. Like, I had several conversations with people and they've said about doing that. I don't know, I guess people just view things differently. And also drama, like, what the hell? Now listen, I'm a sucker for a little bit of tea, a little bit of juice, a little bit of goss, so I'm not hating on this in any way, shape or form, but I feel like it's become a bit of like, what's the word, like a bit catty, like a bit like school girly, and it's just a bit like, oh. I'm not actually here to judge and my opinion really makes no difference whatsoever, but I'm just like chatting to you guys like you're my friends. I don't know, YouTube's a funny place. Oh my god, I drink so much. My Coke is like already here. And by the way, I'm not aiming at anyone in particular. I'm just saying in general, the fun part of YouTube is slowly getting taken away and people are seeing it as like competitors, like YouTubers are competitors. But it's like, we all do the same thing here. So why are we trying to compete to each other? We all sit down in front of a camera and record and edit and upload it, you know? I'm happy to just sit here and eat my chicken nuggets because this is quality content. Okay, I kind of want to get off talking about YouTube because it like low-key bores me a little bit because it's probably nothing you've not heard before. I feel like this is about to get serious and I'm going to turn into serious jorts for a bit, which I can do. If you didn't know that, I can be a little bit more serious sometimes. So a huge topic that I had from you beautiful people was about self-love and confidence. How have I learned to love myself and have the confidence, you know, because I do a job that requires me to like put myself out there and not give a crap about what people think about me. I guess a lot of you think that I have gone past that step and I've gained that like confidence and self-love, but I mean, like, self-love and confidence is not an easy thing, especially living in the society that we live in these days. It's so intimidating. And this literally, okay, I lose brain cells thinking about this, okay? Society, for some reason, has put a stamp on what perfect is, because perfect is a thing. Real talk, though, who has chosen what that looks like? Who has put that stamp on that look and been like, that's, you know, that's goals, like, that's how we should all look? Like, oh, hell to the no, man. Like, think about it, right? If we all looked like that, how would we stand out? What would make us different from anybody else, and how boring would that be? I'm not down for that. I think I've kind of just got to a point in my life where I've accepted that there's only one of me. This is how I look. I'll embrace it and I'll love that because I'm gonna be with this for the rest of my life. And to be happier, that's just what you gotta do. You gotta get these images out of your head of what is perfect and just put your own stamp on it. How cool is it when you think about it? You're the only one of you. That's unique and that's so cool. So love that. I know people say this and it's so cliche to say, but life is way too short to care about what other people think. If you wanna do something, do it. Self-love and confidence kind of come hand in hand, but just do you. There is nothing more exciting and more interesting than you being you. I'll be scrolling through Instagram, for example, and I'll see like, oh my god, all these girls, blah 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 blah, and I'll be like, oh my god, like, why don't I look like that? with my McDonald's in the middle of the night, like, ugh.
I'm sitting here saying all this, and I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys. I don't always feel confident and, like, have that self, have that self-love, because I am a 20-year-old girl, and I have insecurities and things I don't like about myself, just like any other boy and girl, you know? Just because I do YouTube doesn't make me not a real human being with feelings. And I'm exactly the same. I have days where I wake up and I'm like, ugh, no, I hate this about me. Then other days I'm like, okay, cool. Like, I'm kind of feeling myself today. And that's so fine. That is so normal. But all that I'm saying is learn to love yourself a little bit more, and just be confident in your own skin. It is a beautiful thing that you look like you and nobody else looks like you, you know? Strut your stuff, girls and boys. Strut your stuff. There is no way you're gonna please everyone in this world. And I'm cool with that, man. Like, okay. Then you walk down your lane and I'll walk down mine. Don't let someone's opinion of you affect the way you portray yourself or feel about yourself. Just live your life for you. Don't care about what people say or think about you, because you're gonna be so much happier. And happiness is way better looking than someone who wants to comment on everything you do, because that's ugly. I feel like a therapist. Therapist George. Wow, a lot of you asked me about sex, as in my first time, when I think it's right to do it, etc, etc. That didn't surprise me though, because I know a lot of you are older, and kind of more my age, and I'm so open and easy to talk about this stuff. I mean, mum and dad, if you are watching, you might just want to, like, skip forward a couple minutes or something. Loads of you ask me when the right time is to lose your virginity. And, like, for real, you'll just know. I didn't lose my virginity until I was 17. And that's quite late. Like, a lot of my friends had already done it. But me, I am someone who has to feel so comfortable. It's kind of, a scary thing. Especially going into it when you don't know what it's going to be like. Is it going to hurt? Is it not? Like, you're worried about, like, what you look like. You're worried about how the other person's going to feel. I don't know. I just wanted to do it where I felt so, so comfortable. So I did it when I was 17 and in a relationship. It was my last relationship before me and Elle's now. And I felt completely comfortable with him, and it made the experience way easier. That's for sure. There's no, like, right age or right time. If you feel that it's right and you feel comfortable. I just wasn't going to let anybody make me feel like I should have lost it already. I was like, nope, I'm waiting. Don't get me wrong, I knew it wasn't gonna be like the movies. I was like, I'm waiting for the right person, because I need, like, if this hurts, I need to be with someone who can be like, exit. Which, speaking about pain. Ooh. Now, not to put any of you off, okay? Not to put any of you off. Mine hurt like a bitch. I felt like my vagina splitting in two. Is that too much to say on the internet? Not to get, like, really deep, because some of you might not, like, be like, okay, Jordan, like, we get that you're comfortable talking about it, but that is way too far. We tried and I couldn't do it. It hurt so much. And I was like, okay, right, let's stop. Today is not the day. We'll try again soon, but, like, not now. And then a week later, we did it and it hurt a lot less, but it still hurt me. And honestly, the first a good few months, it still hurt. Like, there was no, I was like, why? I thought I was abnormal. I was like, I'm that small? Or is he that big? I don't know. It was like the weirdest thing. And I was like, I'm abnormal. There was something wrong with me. It surely should be hurting by now. Like, I don't get it. Obviously now, it's so fine. Literally doesn't hurt at all. But then it's weird because obviously I speak to my friends about it. And they tell me, like, I have a lot of friends that are like, mine didn't hurt one bit. It just depends on the person, which is why I am saying to you guys, my only thing, my only little, like, mumsy advice, be comfortable. Like, so if it does hurt, you're comfortable enough to be like, okay, let's stop. Oh no, hiccups, you've got to be kidding me.
They ask you how you are, and you just have to say that you're fine when you're not.
I was out last night and I had hiccups like the whole night. It was like the most annoying thing ever. I actually meet some of you on nights out and it's so funny. Like, my apologies if I'm like a drunken hot mess. We're just out here having a good time. Why was that chip really hard? Got that thumb now. Honestly, that aeroplane may as well have been in my room with me. Speaking of, you know, that kind of thing, relationship update, life update, like that. Everything is good. Me and Elliot are really good. Yeah. A lot of you were asking about our living situation. Do we live together?
If not, when are we planning to move out, etc, etc, etc. As of right now, we don't live together. I live at home with my mum, my dad, and my sister. So we originally were actually going to go and rent somewhere. So within the next few months, we were going to go rent. I'm lucky enough to be in a position where I can actually get a mortgage. And I feel like money-wise, it just makes sense for me to get a mortgage than waste my money on renting. So we've decided to kind of like delay the whole thing and get a mortgage next year. So that's really exciting. We're not like in a rush or anything. I think these things, you know, you need to be like sure and make sure it's the right time because it is a huge investment. I mean, I'm happy where I am. He's happy where he is. Obviously, in an ideal world, we would love to live together so that it just makes it easier to see each other, have that little bit more freedom. I'll have the space that I need. Space is the biggest thing for me. Like right now, you guys see this background. If you see around me, it's just a hot friggin' mess. But not only that, I just have no room to literally put anything. Apart from that, yeah. We're all Gucci. Speaking of relationships, one of the biggest things that you guys asked me about was heartbreak. Now, I mean, I am no freaking expert. Like, that's for sure. I've never really been heartbroken necessarily. I've only ever been in one other proper relationship before Elliot. And that was like a little bit of a crazy relationship. I've never really spoken about my past relationship. It was so unhealthy. And it got to the point where I just couldn't do it anymore. It was so emotionally involved that it just got to a point that anything I did, it was making him... It's so hard to talk about because I can't speak for him. He's not here. Do you know what I mean? But from my point of view, the relationship... It just wasn't gonna work. It was the wrong place, the wrong time. I mean, it's so fine now though. Like, there's no ag or like awkwardness between us at all, which is so. Nice to have, no matter who broke up the relationship. It's just so nice to have that like settled point. Don't get me wrong, when we first broke up, there was no way that was gonna happen. What I'm trying to say is that I've never really had to deal with heartbreak in the sense of being broken up with. I kind of did it, but I didn't want to do it, if you know what I mean. So I kind of have dealt with that side of it. So it's kind of heartbreak in a way. It was like heartbreak that you didn't want, but you had to do it for each other's happiness, which is the weirdest. But actually, you know what I'm going to tell you guys this? I wasn't going to tell you guys, but I will, because we're like a family here. Me and Elliot actually split up. Okay, this is going to sound so dumb, okay? It was for less than 24 hours, but it happened. It was one of the hardest things to deal with. Obviously, I'm not going to go into the deets and what happened. And the best way to deal with it, I would say, genuinely, like, speak to someone. Or if you don't actually want to speak to someone, okay, this is going to sound crazy. You're going to be like, Jordan, you've lost your goddamn mind, girl. You've lost your mind. Speak your feelings out loud. And if you need to cry, cry. Even if it's not to anyone, just literally let it out into the world, because bottling it up is the worst feeling ever. And that's when it builds up and gets worse and worse and worse. Whereas if you just let it out. And also, this is like a really, really obvious one, but surround yourself with the people that make you the happiest, because they will support you in a way that no one else will. What I mean by that is they support you in a way that you won't necessarily sit there and speak about the situation, because that just brings it all back up again, and then you feel sad again, and then you start crying again, and then it's just like going back to the beginning. But it will be in a way that's like, I know what's happened and I'm here for you, but I'm gonna make you feel better and happier. And that is the best way to recover. So it's really indirect. It's like, you know they care, but they're not like being really direct and being like, okay, you okay? It's just like, look, I'm here for you. Let's go out. Let's do something to take your mind off of this. And they're the kind of people that you need in your life, you know, close friends, family, that kind of thing. Ooh, that is a smooth bun. Don't the top of a cheeseburger just look really satisfying? Wow. Real question is, who eats the gherkin inside a cheeseburger? I literally love gherkins. I could eat them raw. Honestly, that's just why I get a cheeseburger. Like, F the cheeseburger, just get the gherkin. I'm joking. But I do like gherkins. What I would say is, always put your mindset in a good place, even if the breakup was not what you wanted. I'm not quite sure why I'm clapping. This is probably gonna sound so cliche, okay, but it is so goddamn true. There is plenty more fish in the sea, and it's definitely not gonna feel like that at the time. I'm gonna be like, right, that's it. I'm not gonna find it. Oh, I'm mad my entire life, and I'm just gonna be by myself. And remember, if he or she dumped your ass, And you deserve better than that. And you will get better than that. And it's as simple as that. Well, that's actually not that simple, is it? Relationships are freaking complicated, man. Rather enjoy my cheeseburger, you know? Honestly, I'm that bitch who will like take a bite of something, just one bite, and need a drink. I'm like, bite, drink, bite, drink. You know some people who like can eat a whole meal and not have a drink? Like, what kind of sorcery is that? I need to moisten the esophagus. Oh my god, guys, I have someone I need to show you, okay? Come on! Come on! Hey, good girl! Oh, she can smell the food, girl! I see you! Okay, guys, look! Hello! Is she just not the cutest little thing you've ever seen? This is our new little doggy. Oh, I got lipstick on your head. She's called Siren and she's a greyhound. We got her from a retired racing greyhound place. She's 5 as well, by the way, and she's so well behaved. She loves cuddles. Like, she will legit just sit here and like, let me cuddle you, won't you? Look how cute she is with her ears up, you guys. Do you not just die? Had her for a week, not even that. So, you're such a sweetheart, aren't you? I just want to hug you all the time. All the time. I will leave you be now. You can do what you want now. Like, she's still here. You just want to stay, don't you? Because you just want cuddles. That's all she ever wants, is just to be loved. Don't we all, Hans? Don't we all? Oh, look, you just see her little head peeping. Don't you? Yeah, that's my mood too. Okay, guys, I'm like super full. I haven't even like finished everything, but I'm super full and I feel like I've spoken a lot. Trust me, there is a lot more that, the sass. There is a lot more that I could speak about, but I don't want this video to be like so long because I talk for England anyway. But yeah, if you did enjoy this video, don't forget to smash that thumbs up button. And if you do want to see a little bit more of me, if you haven't already subscribed, don't forget to do that before you go. And also turn on that little notification bell so then you don't miss an upload from me. Anyway, that is everything from me. So guys, thank you so, so much for taking the time to watch this video. It's a little random, a little crazy, a little bit all over the place. But that kind of explains my life, so. Thank you for watching. I love every single one of you so, so much. And I will see you all in the next one. Mwah. Bye. Are you going to say bye to everyone? You wanna say bye? She says bye. Siren says bye. I wish someone would pamper me like this. Like, give me head rubs. And give me a head rub. She's like, bitch, no way. Peace up. A-town down. Look at the burger, just chilling in the background. You want a chicken nug, don't you? Chicken nug nugs. Chicken nug nugs. All in my town. Chicken nug nugs. Chicken nug nugs. They are number one. Yeah, everything around me.